First of all, thank you very much. I'm sure you all know I'm into sports, and sports is one avenue that the youth can show their talent, and I expect that it's one area that I'll pursue very vigorously. We're looking at building a sports complex in Ladi Adekutupon on a commercial basis, not so that the youth, because when you look at the history of Ladi, we produce a lot of athletes, a lot of sportsmen, a lot of good players. So we'll be looking at that. We also be looking at ensuring that the municipal assembly within Ladi Adekutupon, every private school here has some form of a sports, not even dedicated but even shared sports, something like a park, so that physical education will be a key part of the curriculum. Because I recall some of us when we were in school, we could play we could engage in a lot of sporting activities because we had opportunity. So PE will be a key part in the educational curriculum plan of all schools in Ladi Adekutupon to ensure that those youth who have physical talent can have an avenue to express them.
You said private schools. Is it going to be only for private schools?
Or all schools, government schools and private schools.
Okay. Is this something which is part of the manifesto of the MP?
It's something that we have thought about as a party. Although we haven't expressly stated in our manifesto, but it's something that we have thought as a party. But I want to start that from Ladi Adekutupon. You see, my mission while I'm into politics is to make this constituency the most preferred place to reside in Ghana.
So are you doing this from your own resources, or is going to be done by the MPP?
No. And the MPP doesn't fund projects. As I said to you, the sports complex is going to be private sector finance. It's going to be private sector finance. And then, as for the curriculum, making sure that PE is an integral part, we'll do it from the municipal assembly level to ensure that these things are catered for. Schools that don't have dedicated parks, we'll see how the limited parks in the country could be shared as a start. But going forward, we'll see how we could develop the community, must develop community sports parks so that the schools can benefit from that.
Where do you intend to get this private sporting facility to develop talent? Where do you intend specifically to let it be?
I have two places in mind. You know, we have a large vast of land behind a trade fair called Chado. There's a vast land of land there, and so that's where I'm trying to earmark so that we could and it's going to be on commercial basis. It's going to be on commercial basis, so it'll be able to fund itself and generate and make a return on the investment that is going to be made. But it's going to be facilitated by the God willing, when I'm the MP, with the municipal assembly and the traditional leaders.
Have you approximated how much specifically this one will cost?
Well, being an entrepreneur, we haven't done the bill of quantities yet, but I believe that it's something that, look, when you have an idea, when the time comes, you put it into reality, you look at what it would take to do it, and then once you are committed and are willing and you have the competency to make sure it happens, it will happen. Because you see, it's going to be a business venture. It's like any other product that you design, like any other business. Once you have a business idea, you put it into practice, you must look for sources of funding to finance that.
Zoom in on House of Hope. You were made the MD just recently. I continue as the MD of House of Hope.
As I stand here, I'm the acting MD of Hearts of Oak, and I'm continuing until we come to the point where the board will have to review the situation, and then we'll see what the way the club will go.
But do you have the intent of maintaining the position as a permanent MD of the club?
Well, I mean, it's up to the board, but I believe that I want to ensure that whatever happens, Hearts of Oak becomes the leading sporting brand in Ghana. And I mean, wherever it's possible, wherever I find myself, whatever I engage in, where it's possible, I'll try as much as possible to ensure that I transform the club with the help of the board to be the best club in Ghana.
Recently, we were made to understand that about 13 players of Hearts of Oak have been offloaded. Why the decision to offload as many as 13 players?
Well, first of all, that's not correct. But, I mean, we are in the off-season. Just like any other club, any other organization, you look at how to improve, how to build to build a stronger team, how to build capacity. So it's all part of the process of ensuring that we build a better team.
The club brought on Sergio Tragu to take over from Kenechi, but recently he was demoted to Arras. What was the brain behind the club decision to demote Sergio when initially he came for Arras and you could give him the senior job?
First of all, as you yourself have said rightly, Sergio was not demoted. He had to revert to his original position while he came in. Sergio had to fill in the gap because Kenichi left unceremoniously. And at the time Kenichi left, his assistant, Yaperko, was also not available. So we had no choice but to look internally and to ensure that we get someone to fill in the gap and to see whether whilst he fills in the gap, things will go well. So in the end, he was asked to revert to the position he occupied before he was asked to fill in the gap. So he was not demoted. He was asked back to go back to where he was originally.
Is Yaperko going to be the senior coach of Hearts of Oak substantively?
The board, we've not met us. The board hasn't met. We are yet to meet. We're going to meet in the next few days. And when the board takes that, when we get to that point, we take that decision. I'm sure you know Hearts of Oak will let you know.
But are you considering other options to come in and support the technical team?
The issue is not really being considered at all. I mean, when we meet at the board level, I'm sure the board will take stock of what's happening, and I'm sure the board will take the decision of where we have to go.
There were times we heard that Hearts of Oak were going to float shares. How far would that be?
I think we've already floated shares. We were going to what we call the rights issue. The rights issue is where existing shareholders are given opportunity to expand their stake in the club, and it's still on course. But we've already floated shares. Hearts of Oak is publicly owned now, but we're going to do a rights issue to expand those who have the shares to buy more into that. But that is still on track.
How far would the structures we were told will be ready at Kobiman?
Well, we expect that all things being equal this season, Hearts of Oak, we expect, subject to approval of the board, all things being equal, Hearts of Oak move to Kobiman to start the whole team, the senior team, the Auroras who are playing in Division 2, and then the under 17 Royal Oaks. We expect that from the beginning of the season, next season, Hearts of Oak should start training at Kobiman.
From the beginning of next season, is that 2017, 2018?
2016, 2017.
Thank you very much.
It's a pleasure. Thank you.